My name is Bob Stevens, and I've been an iridologist for over 30 years, over 35 years. And I've read a lot of eyes in those years. And I came up many, many, many moons ago, 20-some years ago, I came up with a system of, instead of labeling what was wrong for people, discovering what strength is returning. Much of what will happen in interacting with you today with the new Bio Optic Holography student practitioners is they will be asking you questions from what they see in your iris, which is all the information in your physical body, the sclera of your eye, the white of your eye, which is what we're attracting in from others, our pupil, how we send and receive, and the activity and tone and shape of our pupil, and what we're seeing in our eyes. Left eye is right brain, left side of the body, mom genetically. Right eye is left brain, right side of the body, dad genetically. And what we're seeing is what we've taken on genetically and experientially, what we've made up and proved to be true, and what's operating in our lives frequently other than consciously. And the entire goal of bio-optic holography is to engage a person, translate what's seen in their eyes into something they can understand, memories, thoughts, words, experiences, and then help identify the strengths returning for that person. And we see fibers change in our eye. Something which is what used to be genetic or not changeable, which is what many iridology systems say, I have been watching change, fibers change for over 30 years. So that's not true for me. And so I know the structure of our iris is a structure of genetics, of DNA. And, you know, I've heard a long time, you can change your DNA, you can change. If it doesn't change the eye for me, we didn't change our DNA. And how many here who have been in the class have seen your iris change? And we're just having conversations with people. We're not doing a whole bunch of nutrition, even though I work a lot with nutrition. We're not doing this thing called body electronics right now. And yet, we're engaging thought, word, and emotional patterns. Is it emotional sometimes, yes or no?
Yes.
And yet, you know, it's what isn't going to happen here is, I mean, as long as we're doing our job, no one here will be telling you what's wrong with you. How many like it?
Yes.
How many don't go to certain places just because you'd rather not have someone tell you what's wrong with you or label you? How many know what I'm talking about?
Yes.
No, rather not have that. What we're doing is engaging you to understand, ultimately, how things happened, where they come from, and what they turn into. Then find something else. Find exactly how it happened and begin to tie it together in what your strengths are as they return. This is very intimate and very powerful. What I'm going to do first is just, we have about a half an hour of me showing you some of what's going on in the resurrection of our lives. What you're seeing here, I'm going to take you through a number of slides. The iris of the eye is our physical body. All the information, left eye is mom, right eye is dad. What the little vessels and colorations that are in the white of our eye, the sclera, is everything outside of our physical form, people, places, conditions, and things, which we're attracting in according to our inner belief. And the sclera changes dramatically, as well as our iris changes. See the red in here, everybody? That person is receiving. Of course, they love sugar, so what they're receiving usually is lots of sugar, probably lots of alcohol. So just for, whoops, did I say that? So now, I'm just showing you the differences of eyes. Every fiber means something. The color means something. The rings in our eyes are stress rings. Those are internal dialogue, negative internal dialogue, waiting for positive affirmation, decree, or prayer. We can tell what's happening with the intestines. This would be a prolapse transverse colon. This is the area that feeds the brain. That person energetically most likely has got a whole bunch of genius they don't want to activate or remember. We're going to read it as, oh, it's time to activate your genius. Sometimes orange is in our eye, or bright red, which are heavy metals and chemicals, which really support confusion. And it's all upgradable. There's little areas that are the I can'ts. Everything we do is going to translate to thought, word, and emotional patterns. This is called a lymphatic rosary, also called a tophi. And these are I can'ts, I can't, I can't. And when it's orange, it's I can't, and confusion is there. And maybe some old really bitterness is hiding in there. Every fiber is translatable. The shape of the pupil, the size of the pupil, means something. The waviness of the fiber is hyperactivity. The density of the fiber is our ability. It's like thicker wire. We can carry more stress. This person can do all lots of stress. And yet they tend to be a little hyper. Got to, have to, must, should. If you'll take a look at these eyes right here, do you see that kind of hazel green underneath there? Everybody see it? This is actually a blue eye, just as blue as this one. Now, it's a trick to walk up to somebody, read their eyes, and, well, yeah, blue eyes, and they go, I'm out of here. Thank you very much. Yeah, right, buddy. Got it? And yet, if we study it and all of a sudden start bringing light back into our beings, and I'm not saying a brown eye is any whatever than a blue eye. You cannot compare a blue eye to a brown eye or any other eye. You can only compare your eye to itself. If we move upscale, our eye gets lighter. If we move downscale, our eye gets darker. And you cannot compare one color eye to another, only to itself. You can see now in this particular eye, you can start to see some of that blue in there. Everybody see it?
Yeah.
And the eye, some people might say, well, this is a green eye. Well, it's green in color. It's actually a blue eye for my system. This is the pooper. How many know what I'm talking about? Don't make your brown eyes blue. That's what I got to say about it. And what we see is genetic patterns from mom, genetic patterns from dad. We see trauma early in life, the slightly misshapen pupil there, which means we're actually, once we realize we're a radiant sun, we're here to reshape our world. This is the brain area. And look at the difference, yes or no? There's a world, there's a huge difference of who we are. And it's a perfect map of our feminine, receptive, intuitive side and our outgoing, rational, masculine, action, word side. And when we can put our receiving side with our doing side, our I with our M, we have manifestation. Scripture says it this way, not religion. It says when our eye is single, the body is full of light. It also says, if you see a twig in your brother's eye, take the log out of your own. And having been an iridologist for over 35 years, I really took it to heart. My job is to see perfection. Every single person here who will be looking in your eyes, their job is to see perfection, to reach right through and discover the strength returning while they don't need to get you to change anything. They're just here to help you have an understanding of what might be being returned to you. So remember, their job is to see perfection. So from my heart, I request you empower them to see perfection. That's their job. We've had a lot of days of very powerful training to see perfection very accurately. This is our skin. Outer edge, it goes stomach lining, stomach, large and small intestine, ductless glands, organs, bones and muscles, lymph, blood vessels, capillaries, skin. And if we don't want to feel, if the world is a harsh place, then we can shut down feeling, and that's our skin. If it's true our greatest weakness should be our greatest strength, then we're here actually to love what we feel and to positively influence our environment instead of take on all the stuff from our environment and need to shut down. And once we start waking up, the fibers start reaching back out. There's a chart where we can just actually see what's going on, and which they'll be using. And it's extremely accurate. Again, every fiber is translatable. White is hyper. Little dark area right there is hypo. It's all translatable. Over the years, there have been a number, this is 1886, there have been a number of charts that have surfaced on what the iris and sclera and pupil represent. So we're standing on the shoulders of a tremendous amount of research, love, and devotion by many people over the years in many different systems. And these charts, people began to notice, wow, there's something happening. One of my major people I study was working with an owl, and the owl struggled to get away, and the person holding him fractured his leg and saw a speck show up instantly in his eye, and that's what got him involved in studying the iris of the eye as it relates as a map to the physical body. And then they started applying it to humans. And over the years, people began to build on each other's knowledge and understanding. Until Dr. Bernard Jensen, what I consider the grandfather of iridology in this country, gathered a lot of the information, traveled the world, and brought together these different systems, plus understanding his own. There's a lot of information here, yes or no? And over the years, it started getting clearer and clearer with confirmation of what's starting to happen in the iris of our eye. Bio optic holography is the study of the iris, sclera, and pupil as they relate holographically, like a holographic image, to three reference beams: thought, word, and feeling. We are actually three-dimensional, and we are holographic images of invisibility becoming visible here now. And so the cause of our being and world, in my view, is thoughts, words, and feelings. The word has become flesh, so to speak. And the map is available through our iris, sclera, and pupil. When we look in each other's eyes, on some level, we know everything about each other. Now, how many have a sense of that? How many looked in someone's eyes and on some level you knew a lot? Whether you could put it in words or not is different. So just remember, we're standing today on the shoulders of hundreds of people who have gone before us. And I've been at it over almost 39 years. To the point where that's just the brain area. We are today. This is Jensen's chart from 1977. Dr. Bernard Jensen, and he's one of my idols, really. He really produced so much good stuff. He's just an amazing human being. And there's the chart that we will be using today. This is my chart. It has some changes to it over the years. If we're looking at our eye and we're looking up through, and this is our iris, we have fibrils. And we also have blood vessels that potentially will be reading. Definitely blood vessels in the sclera. This would be more the iris, this would be more the sclera. When the iris or the sclera actually reveals a blood vessel, that's information, which is so accurate. It's phenomenal. If it's a little teeny red spot, it's a person. If it's a little teeny blue spot, it's an old, I don't want to be here anymore about that thought. If it's a big loop, it's actually a belief system that we're taking on from others. And it's translatable and it's upgradable. Jensen says that there's four levels. Bright white in the eye, if we suppress it, it goes to subacute, chronic, and degenerative. I prefer to work with the iris of our eye and the sclera relative to consciousness. So I'm going to have seven levels here. And we will, our system, which I'll show you, goes from unconsciousness, apathy, grief, fear, anger, pain, and enthusiasm. And we start walking up scale. And I believe that's where we're able to get such a dramatic, quick shift in our eyes, because we're dealing with it at a causal level. And that would be bright white, hyper, got to, have to, must. There's a constitution. Thicker it is, the more we can handle energy. The wavier, more open it is, the more we're losing energy. These are actually just thought forms, belief systems, and a lack of integrity and vitality. Distinction here, you see white, and if we suppress it, it gets darker, darker unto black. We actually have seven in our system. What I share with everyone is when they light your eye from a particular way and it's from the side, they might see something that looks black. That's a shadow. So we get to be really ultra aware of whether it's a shadow or not. So they'll be moving the light around. I'm still aware of this today. I read something for half an hour and finally moved my light and saw it was a shadow. Duh, I know about that. So inside of every fibril, there's another bundle of fibers. Once we got the right type of magnification in our magnifying scopes, they found there's another 10,000 fibrils inside of there. It may be that every hair on our head is numbered and actually shows up in the iris of our eye. The nervous system shows up. The eye, right eye is left brain. It's real simple stuff here. Left eye is right brain. What we're watching is the plexus. This is our stomach lining, central nervous system, and it communicates to our autonomic nervous system, which communicates all the way out to the skin, through organs and glands, bones, tissues, muscles. If we blow it up, we can see that there's this beautiful plexus here. And it's awake or not. Usually we can tell just what happened in first, second, third trimester just by the iris alone. Our glandular system shows up. And we equate, this would be enthusiasm, anger, or enthusiasm, pain, anger, thyroid, parathyroid, thymus, which is love, heart, fear, grief, apathy would be in there with spleen, and then reproductive, unconsciousness. Reproductive system shows up. Structural system shows up. Lymphatics. And we talk about this, and everyone say, I can.
I can
is what makes the lymphatic system move. I can't is what creates a trapped, what's called trapped plasma protein. I can, in languaging, the basis of what I'm sharing is how important it is to be conscious in our thought, word, emotional patterns. Respiratory system, how important it is to have life and enthusiasm. Circulatory system, digestive system, the colon, this would be right eye, colon reflexes all the way to the brain. This would be the left eye, colon reflexes. We have 15 very excited people, and maybe 15 more. The 15 that I was speaking of first is the people who've been together for 6 days, and in this event, plus 7 days, plus other events together, to share with you what they are learning and understanding and remembering about moving up scale. So please know, as far as bio-optic holography is concerned, the individuals who will be sitting with you and very lovingly sharing with you their experience and guiding you to the best of their capability, very prayerfully and in the highest way, guiding you, helping you according to their experience. So I'm asking you to be gentle on them. They know to be very gentle on you. They know what it took. Yes? You can hear the truly, it's amazing. It's beautiful. And I mean, for me, our eyes are the windows of our soul. And they reveal a map, a beautiful map of our way home according to each individual's belief system. It's not like you get to jump into our belief system. It's not the way this works. We're only here, or I'm here when I do it with someone. Bio-optic holography is to guide that person into their own strength returning according to their beliefs. Clear? So this is a, even though it's highly spiritual, it's not religious at all, and yet it's highly spiritual or spirit-filled. It's about love returning. It's about light returning. It's about metabolism returning. It's about our genius being restored with exacting specificity, real time, here now.